Day 35. Another 5 hours to add to my buzz tally. Heading south across Bolivia. The landscape was awesome. Mini monument valleys giving way to incredible plains of llamas wandering. The Bolivian plateau, as far as the ragged horizon. Valleys like white chalk with different colored stratas breaking out. We came off the plateau as we finally approached the Uyumi. The flats ahead. Flats begetting flats. The sun lit the distant sand.
Arrived in Uyumi. Uyumi. Uyumi.
Who is the car?
So tomorrow I start my 3-day salt flat tour. So I'll be once again completely out of touch, which, to be honest, will probably be a relief for the amount of videos and photographs I'm throwing at you on a continual basis. Must get quite wearing. They looked amazing coming in on the bus, the salt flats. I'm off for the distance with the sun just lighting them up. And I just spent the last half an hour trying to find my tour agency. I think I just found that. I rang them a second ago. I think I just found that the directions they gave me were pretty poor. Anyway, sun's down, haven't eaten. Oh, look, a tiny train. There's a train scrapyard here too, which should be quite fun to see. So yeah, 3 days of touring the salt flats will drop me off in Chile. And now all I have to do is fly to Santiago and then fly home. So this time next week, I'll already be in Barcelona. No, I won't. I will be in Barcelona for one night before flying back the next morning. There's lots of little mini things all over here. Anyway, as you get to my hostel.
I can't say it feels massively safe wandering around this, what appears to be rather desolate town, as the sun has just set. I'm crossing some rails here. It does remind me of a time, must be 20 years ago now, when I was in Thailand on my own, and there was a man at the bus station who was offering lifts into town, and I was convinced it was a scam, and so I decided to walk, thinking the bus station was where it was on my map, my Lonely Planet gravel map. But it wasn't. It had moved the year before, and it was a 2-hour walk on a motorway. There were some snakes, I think. Anyway, by the time I got to town, the sun had set, and because I still thought that I had just misunderstood the scale of the map, I thought that I was on the road my hostel was on. So I spent a good while walking along, trying to get into people's houses, thinking there were hostels, dogs barking as I went up and rattled the blinds, and dogs came running out in the pitch black. Terrifying. Eventually I caught it on that I was at the wrong side of town, across the bridge to a much more friendly, much more lit part of town. The part was like this. It was quite dark. And found my hostel only to find behind the desk a man who had been at the bus station offering lifts. He'd been offering lifts to the hostel I was going to. Just a little tale as I walk in the night through the Uyumi, which kind of kept me sane a little bit, because here's my hostel.
Peekaboo.
Not too bad.
Time to go on the steep trains. absolutely insane.
Oh, we're brakes.
Flats, after a slightly confusing explanation from our English speaking guide, who, like every English speaking guide. Yeah.
Maybe.
Standing on an island made of coral in a sea full of salt, covered in gigantic cactuses. Totally normal stuff for planet Earth. Weird, but very beautiful.
There's not much to add, really. We just drove across the vasts of Bolivia, scraping along the western border with Chile, in and out and in again. Beauty all around. There's not much I can add.
Well, look the other side.
Just look at the llamas, look at the mountains, and look at the volcanoes.
Day two of the Salt Lake tour, Salt Flat tour. We've left the Salt Flats far behind, and now we're up very near the Chilean border at a mirador for various volcanoes, all of which are covered in clouds. The sheer scale and majesty of the landscape is difficult to comprehend, to be honest. Coral everywhere. So yeah, it's very impressive. Very impressive place to be. Welcome back to the 4x4 after visiting a lake of flamingos. Thunder rambling away in the distance. Again, ridiculously beautiful place. Flamingos. Yeah, it's kind of incredible. They call it the colorful lake, and it's where a lot of flamingos get their pink color from the bacteria in the lake. Not bacteria, from the micro. I'm very tired, sorry. The microbes, micro, you know, tiny lads, Tiny pink lads. You know the ones. You know the ones. Of course you do. I'm walking out to another viewing platform. Yeah, just a big old pink lake full of pink flamingos. Llamas at the side. Very gorgeous. So yeah, it's an incredible place, this national park. Very difficult to capture on camera, but incredible. Microorganisms, that's what I was trying to say. Simple. So yeah, as you can see, lake all around at the end of this soul tour. It's been a good tour. Yeah, lots of lagoons today, salt yesterday. Tomorrow, hot springs, and I think more lagoons. I've seen a lot of lagoons. I'm not entirely sure what the difference between a lagoon and a lake is. I always thought the lagoon was a thing created by the sea being cut off, you know, in a Caribbean island, but apparently these are lagoons too. So there you go. Day two, pretty rustic. I love it.
We were up before dawn on the last day, but I was up considerably earlier. I thought at first it was food poisoning, but as the day wound on, I realized that having spent 6 weeks at altitude crossing the Andes, now, at the very last day, I had somehow come down with a very severe case of altitude sickness. We went to see the geysers, ostensibly to watch the sunrise, but there was no sun to be seen. I hid behind some rocks and threw up, and we carried on. I don't think I've ever felt as bad in my life, and the whole day was spent that way. As such, I haven't documented my sauna journey with some flamingos, which made me feel even worse, or much else. Just the usual vistas as we slowly inch towards my final country, Chile. Finally, after a day of feeling genuinely terrible, we approached the Chilean frontier. A couple of huts on a mountain and a cliff.
I've arrived at my final city, my final country, Chile. This was the last day of our Salt Lake tour. Salt Flat tour. Oh dear. I believe I have come down with altitude sickness sometime in the night. Today I've just been completely without energy and feeling genuinely awful. So I'm gonna go find my hostel and sleep.
Somewhere on the first day, I asked my guide, was the town where Butch and Sundance shot quite nearby. He didn't understand until I described them as the Bandidos Yankees. And so I started posing as Bandidos Yankees. Here are some of those photographs, encouraged heavily by our guide.
Yes.
Banditos. Yankees.
Yankees.
Yankees pose. Banditos. Yeah,
these
more than all of you.